Let me again open the master. This symmetric and skew symmetric matrix and their properties, these are all discussed na, today, yesterday. So we'll start from this point, okay, adjoint of a matrix. Okay, after learning the definition of adjoint of a matrix, we will discuss interesting property of determinant. Okay, coming to that point later. First, let me define the adjoint of a matrix. Everybody can hear me, na? Okay. So basically, adjoint of a matrix is another square. Suppose A is a square matrix with the cell values aij, small aij. So small a 1 2, small a 1 1, small a 1 2, up to small a 1 n, then small a 2 1, 2 2, 2 n, up to last row will be small n 1, n 2, n n. So this is the capital A. Now, the adjoint of capital A, or sometimes it is called adjugate also, that is also defined by adj this way, this adj of A, adjoint of A, whose elements are the cofactors capital Aij corresponding to the cell value Aij. So, corresponding to the cell values Aij. So, what is cofactor capital Aij? Cofactor capital Aij is very simple. You just eliminate the row and column, that is ith row and jth column, where the Aij is situated, and take the submatrix, that is a submatrix of order n minus 1 into n minus 1. And
sir, some are waiting, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Few students are waiting outside.
Okay, just a minute. So, you are taking the submatrix of order n minus 1, and then with that, you will multiply a sign minus 1 whole to the power I plus j, minus 1 whole to the power I plus j. So that will give you the cofactor. And now, first of all, you just replace all this small aij in capital A with this capital Aij, that is the corresponding cofactor, and then take a transpose of that. Take a transpose of this one, transpose of that. That will give you the, that is the definition, that will give you the adjoint of A. So what I am telling, for a given matrix capital A, whose cell values are small aij, replace all this small aij with capital Aij, where capital Aij is the cofactor. This cofactor is formed by stripping out this row and column where small aij is situated, and taking the remaining n minus 1 row and column, and then multiplying it with minus 1 whole to the power I plus j. So you will get the capital Aij. So first thing, you will replace all small aij with corresponding value of capital Aij, and then you will take a transpose of this thing. Okay, transpose of this thing, that will give you another square matrix of the same order n, and that will be called the adjoint or adjugate of capital A. Is that clear? Okay, so let me calculate one capital Aij. Let me calculate one capital Aij given one small Aij. Okay. So I take one matrix. Okay, let me take this same matrix here. What is the matrix telling me? 1 minus 1 0, 1 minus 1 0 in 2 3 4 2 sorry 2 3 4 then 0 1 2 0 1 2 okay this will be should be within a third bracket customarily okay so this is your capital A okay then what will be adjoint of A first of all you calculate the intermediate matrix capital Aij capital Aij this intermediate matrix you are calculating how will you calculate this thing again take a third bracket okay now tell me how will you calculate this thing so for this one this is small aij this is small aij okay small aij now eliminate this column and row eliminate this first column and first row so you are getting a submatrix of order 1 3 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 okay so what is the value of this thing 3 into 2 6 minus 4 so 2 and 2 into minus 1 whole to the power 1 plus 1 what is the ij value here 1 plus 1 so it will be again 1 so actually 2 then minus 1 so minus 1 is in the second column first row eliminate them so 2 into 2 4 minus 0 4 and with 4 it will be minus 1 whole to the power 1 plus 2 that is minus 4 okay similarly you please tell me what is the third value of the row anyone tell me whether you are getting I will understand
minus 1 sir
minus 1 1 minute
2 sir 2
correctly calculate someone is telling minus 1 someone is telling 2 that means you have some confusion on 1 minute
0 second
सर टू होगा
सर माइनस वन
सर टू
टू ओके लेट मी कैलकुलेट इट दिस इज जीरो सो एलिमिनेट दिस रो एंड कॉलम सो टू इनटू वन टू माइनस थ्री टू and into minus 1 whole to the power 1 plus 3 that is 2 okay everyone is clear
minus 2 sir
this will be minus 2 everyone is sir. Agreeing then tell me
2 sir 2
again 2
yes sir 2 hoga
sir 2
2 kaun sa 2 hoga ye na ye pehla wala पहला वाला की सेकंड वाला बताओ देखो पहला वाला तो ये टू और ये चेंज हो गया माइनस टू ये माइनस टू ठीक है अभी नहीं माइनस टू नहीं है ठीक 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 नहीं है ये टू का अंदर क्या है सेकंड रो फर्स्ट कॉलम बाद हो गया सो माइनस वन इंटू टू माइनस टू ओके देन माइनस वन होल टू दी पावर वन प्लस टू माइनस वन विल बी एडेड सो दैट विल बी टू यू आर फॉरगेटिंग टू कैलकुलेट विथ विथ मल्टीप्लाई विथ माइनस वन होल टू दी पावर आई प्लस जे Don't forget it. Then this will be 3, so it will be multiplied. So 2 into 1, 2. It is also 2. Then 4. So 1 into 1, 0. 1 minus 1. Then this will be so
minus 4.
Minus 4 and into 1. Okay, minus 4. Then?
4, sir. Then 4.
Then 4. Ah, 4. 4. Sorry.
Then
and
1.
Finally?
1.
1. 3 into 1. 3. 1. How 1 is? It will be 3 into 1. 3 minus minus plus 3
minus
2. 3 minus 2. 3 plus 5. 2. 5.
6.
Not only 5. Then minus 1 whole to the power 5. Now the adjoint of this thing, okay, finally the adjoint of this thing, so that
so
will
minus,
be equal to
so minus 4 hoga na sir wahan
idhar bata is idhar
ye wala sir
एक मिनट देख एक मिनट चेक करते हैं तुम ही बताया तो लिख दिया 4 माइनस 0 4 हुआ देन माइनस 1 होल टू द पावर 3 प्लस 2 ये माइनस 4 होगा ठीक ही बताया ठीक है ये माइनस 1 होल टू द पावर 3 प्लस 2 सो माइनस 1 हो जाएगा और इनमें से 4 सही है ना माइनस 4 हाँ ठीक है ये हो जाएगा तो इसका एडजॉइंट क्या हो गया एडजॉइंट हो जाएगा रोज विल बी चेंज टू कॉलम तो 2 2 4 2 2 4 sorry 2 2 minus 4 then minus 4 2 minus 4 minus 4 2 minus 4 and then 2 minus 1 5 2 minus 1 5 everybody can see it so this is your adjoint of A ultimately I can write this is as the adjoint of A okay let us check it whether it is correct or not okay 2 2 minus 4 minus 4 2 minus 4 2 minus 1 5 2 2 4 minus 2 minus 4 2 minus 4 2 minus 1 5 okay it is okay so this is our adjoint of A okay and from this adjoint of A in the last class I was telling you that there is no direct concept of division of matrix A by B but there is a concept of inverse obviously inverse of a matrix and that is defined as that is defined as A inverse. A inverse that is equal to adjoint of A by multiply this is a matrix now multiply this with 1 by dt because this is a scalar so I can take it as a scalar and just like multiplying any matrix cell values with c1 c2 so all cell values will be multiplied with c1 like this so I will multiply the entire cell value with 1 by dt Suppose data is 5, so 1 by 5 will be multiplied with all the cell values. That is the definition of A inverse. And A inverse is one thing. So the property is that A into A inverse that is equal to minus 1. That is equal to the identity matrix of the same order IN okay So I have already calculated adjoint of A. I can calculate the determinant also. But the determinant, tell me here also, I can write the determinant. The determinant equal to 1 into 6 minus 4 minus minus 1, that is plus 1, plus 1 into 2 minus 0, 4 minus 0,
6
plus 0 into some, everything is 0. Okay, so that is equal to 2 and 4, 6. So our A inverse will be 1/6. So let me first write down this thing. Then what I will do? I will multiply every cell with 1/6. That is, this will be 1/3. This will be 1/3 like this. 4/6, that is 2/3. 4/6, that is 2/3. 2/3. This will also 2/3. No, sorry, not 2/3. It will be 4/3 minus 4/3. Okay, this will be 2/6. That is 1/3. 1/3. Okay, isn't it? It's 1/3. It was 2 already. It is again 2/3. This will be 2/3. That is 1/3. Minus 1/6. Minus 1/6 and 5/6. Tell me whether it is okay. Okay. So this is your A inverse. And you can check that if you multiply A with A inverse, that will give you the identity matrix I. That I am not doing here. It will take a lot of time. So on your and your by high pen and paper, you can check this thing. Okay. I hope this calculation and definition of adjoint is clear to all.
Yes, sir.
Bolo.
In adjoint A, sir, in second row,
this one
2 here, I think here is 1, not minus 1.
2 minus, not 2 1.
Yes, sir.
Why 2 1? This is corresponding to 4, so eliminate these two things.
Yes, sir.
4
1 into 1 1 minus 0.
So 1, then what is the sign of this thing? Sign of this thing? 3, 2,
plus
1,
minus,
2, 2,
minus.
2, 3, minus. So minus of 1, minus 1?
Okay, sir.
Say to her. Okay. I've already checked it with the given one. See, it is already given. 2, 2, minus 4, minus 4, 2, minus 4, 2, minus 1, 5, into 1, minus 1. That is the inverse of A. Okay. Now, next, we will discuss one interesting property of sum of determinants, and I will give you one very interesting problem that it is, don't confuse, this is not no new rule, this is not a new rule, but when it is a case of determinant, the way it will be evaluated, that result will be the same. It is that, suppose del 1 is equal to some determinant, I am considering a 3 by 3, A1, B1, C1, row wise, A2, B2, C2, A3, B3, C3, and del 2 is D1, B1, C1, D2, B2, C2, D3, B3, C3. So what is happening here, please note that the first column is differing. The first column in the del 1, it is A1, A2, A3. In del 2, it is D1, D2, D3. But second and third column is same. Second and third column is same. Okay. Then, if they were matrices, then what if I add del 1 plus del 2, they are also matrices. If I change the determinant sign to matrix sign, determinants is just the scalar value of the matrix. So if I take the matrix status of this thing, this quantity, so what you will get if you add del 1 plus del 2, by definition, that will be all the corresponding cell entry will be added. All the corresponding cell entries will be added. Okay, this is the definition. Okay, that is the same unique definition, no problem. I'm not changing that thing. But when I'm calculating determinant, this thing can be written in a slightly different way also. Please check the rule. It will be that if you add del 1 plus del 2, then only the column is differing with value. Only those column will differ with value will be added. So what I'm doing here, A1 plus D1, A2 plus D2, A3 plus D3, that will be our first column. And second and third column, since they are not changing, they will remain same. It will not be that B1 plus B1, 2B1, it is not that. But if you calculate the determinant of del 1 plus del 2, that will be just same with if you add as taking the matrix and then taking the determinant. If you take them as matrix and then add it and then take the determinant, the result will be the same. Okay. But this is a very convenient, handy rule. Okay, some problems can be very easily solved using this rule. Del 1 plus del 2 is equal to this. Similarly, if your another determinant, suppose A1, B1, C1, D2, E2, F2, A3, B3, C3. In that case, if you check the del 2 and del 3, they are differing by only the first row. Okay, the second row is D2, E2, F2. No, the second row is also changing. The first row is also changing. So what is happening? A1, B1, C1, A3, B3, C1. It is changing. It is same with del 1. Okay, so del 1, the first row is A1, B1, C1. In del 3 also A1, B1, C1. Third row is A3, B3, C3. Third row is A3, B3. Only second row is differing. A2, B2, C2 and D2, E2, V2. So if you add del 1 plus del 3, then what will happen? Only this row will be changed, added. A2 plus D2, B2 plus E2, C2 plus F2. And the row, first row, third row will be remain unchanged. That means whatever it is row and column, whichever is differing will be added, other will remain same. Getting? But you cannot apply this rule for del 2 and del 3 because here, more than one column is changing and row is changing. Okay, this way. If you cannot do it this for del 2 and del 3 because none of the row and none of the column is same. None of the row and column is same. So you cannot do it. Are you clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, using this thing, I can please solve this problem. Let Let del R del R that is equal to the matrix, the determinant, this one. Sorry. This will be 2R minus 1 M C R is M plus 1. Here I am writing M square plus 1, here is 2 to the power m, here is, sorry, this should be m plus 1, this should be only r. And this is sine m square this should be sine m and this is sine square M. Now, if this is then so R equal to 1 to M del R del R that is equal to 0. Everybody can see the problem? Now this problem can be solved using this rule. Okay, what is summation of del r, r is equal to 1 to m, what is that? Del 1 plus del 2 plus del 3, this way. Okay, basically the sum of this thing that is equal to del 1 plus del 2 plus del 3. So let me write once again. Del 1 del 2 plus del m, so that is equal to, now tell me, so if you write del 1 plus del 2 plus del n, which row or which column will actually change? Tell me.
First row, sir.
Okay. The first row will be like this. The R is equal to 1, R is equal to 2. So this thing will be changed. So according to this rule, only the first row will be like this. Only the here in this case, second row is changing. In our case, first row is changing. So we will just added this del 1, del 2, del 3, del 4, and we will add this first row. And all this second row and third row will remain constant. Second row and third row will remain constant. Getting? So tell me what will happen. What will happen? Tell me. Let me first write down the entire thing here also. Now, if I add these things, 2r minus 1, tell me what will happen. 2r minus 1, sum over r is equal to sum over r is equal to, I think r should be 0. R should be 0. Otherwise, it will not. R equals 0. It should be 0. Okay. This should be r is equal to 0, starting from 0. Okay. Okay. R is equal to 0. Here is. And this will be sum over r is equal to 0, same thing. Okay, and this will be again only R. Okay. Now tell me what will happen here. What is the result of this thing? 2r minus 1, r is equal to 0 to m. Tell me. Muhammad Tajuddin, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
So what is the result? Can you follow? What will be the result for the summation of 2r minus 1? So you break it, summation of 2r minus summation of 1, 0 to n minus 1 times. Twice of, let me write this thing this way, twice of,
it should be m square plus m minus 1.
Ha, because twice of r, summation of r is m into
so
m plus 1 by 2.
It should be m into m plus 1 by 2.
Ha, m, so 2 is cancelled. So m into m plus 1, that is m square minus m. M square minus n and minus 1, m plus 1 times. So let me write m square. I'm just calculating this thing to write down the value. M square plus m minus m plus 1. Why m plus 1? Everybody is clear. Why m plus 1?
No, sir.
Because minus 1. Actually, you are summing na 2r minus 1. So 2 into 0 minus 1 plus 2 into 1 minus 1 plus 2 into 2 minus 1. So how many times minus 1 is added? M plus 1 times. So 2 into You think this way, 2 into 0 minus 1, that is the first term. What is the second term? 2 into 1 minus 1. What is the third term? 2 into 2 minus 1. So you can take 2 common. So 0, 1, 2, 3 up to m, that is m into m plus 1 by 2, what one of your students told me, answered me. So it is m into m plus 1 by 2 into 2, so m into m plus 1, m square plus m. Okay. Then minus, this will be m plus 1. Because minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, m plus 1 times 0 to m. How many times? 0 to m?
Yes.
M plus 1 times. So that will be equal to m square minus 1. M square minus 1. Okay. M square minus 1. Actually, this should be m square minus 1. This should be m square minus 1. Now, tell me what is the value of MCR? It is combination, okay? NC0, NC1, like this. MC0, MC1, up to MCM. What is that? Tell me. It's okay, this should go in the... what is the value? Tell me. MCR, R from 0 to M. MC0, MC1, MC2, up to MCR, MCM. You have done it in your 11,
M 12. Factorial by R factorial into M minus R factorial.
That is the value of MCR. What is the value of sum of MCR? What is the value of sum of MCR? R is equal to 0 to M. That is MC0, MC1, MC2 up to MCM. This value is 2 to the power M. If you take x plus y whole to the power m, binomial expansion, I've done it in 11, 12. X plus y whole to the power m. The expansion is nc0 x to the power m plus nc1 x to the power n minus 1 into y plus nc2 x to the power n minus 2 into y square up to ncn x y to the power n. And if you put x and y equal to 1, that will give you 2 to the power n equal to nc0 plus nc1 plus up to ncn. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
So this thing will be MC0. This part will be, this part is nothing but, let me calculate one by one, then I will put everything. This will be equal to 2 to the power m. 2 to the power m. Okay. And finally, what is R?
M plus 1.
Yes, M plus 1. Is also 0 to M, M plus 1 times M plus 1. That means using these things, what you can write, this is equal to? Again, write this thing. That will be equal to that will be equal to here also. It is also m square minus n. Just copy it. This will be 2 to the power m. And this will be m plus 1. Isn't it? Now, if the two rows are identical, what we know about a determinant? If the two rows are identical,
zero.
The value is zero.
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 So this value will be zero. Okay. This thing is shown. Actually, there is a trick. This sin m square, sin square m, sin m, is these are all not at all coming into the any role, playing any role. It's just inert. You have to understand that. You have to know, first of all, this special rule of determinant addition, first of all, this thing, okay? And you have to apply this for the first and second row only and nothing else. Okay. Everybody is clear? So I'm not taking the part two. From the next day, I will start the part two. Okay. So bye everyone. Give your attendance and leave.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Okay. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir.
Bye, sir.
Bye, everyone.